We are back on MorningLine. Our guest this morning is Vice Mayor Jim Shulman, talking about several events here in the city of Nashville coming off the 4th of July. Also, we're discussing the decision to have a plea deal in the Delkey Hamburg case. Next up on the horn is Linda. Linda, good morning. Hi, Linda.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'll make this quick. I was just wondering what Nashville is doing to help the families that live in the Paragon Mills, Elysian Fields Road area, where they had the flooding again. I have two friends that live down there, and they've been through two floods, and I guess it's just getting out of control. I don't know what they're going to do, but what is Metro going to help them do?
What can they do? All right. Are you familiar with the situation?
Yeah, I think several floods down there. I believe this is the area where Councilmember Courtney Johnston has been involved. Mm-hmm. If we're going back to the March, mm-hmm. There were homeless folks that were down in that area that also were killed because of mm-hmm. the flood. There were efforts being made immediately to try to figure out what to do. I haven't gotten an update in a little while from Councilmember Johnston, but I know that she was down there when all that stuff, after the March flood, she was down there the whole, like all the time, trying to figure out what to do and how to take care of that situation, including, which is what you have to do. You have to deal with the situation at the time, but then you have to be forward thinking. You have to go, okay, so this happened. What do we do so it doesn't happen again? It's sort of like the fireworks thing and the mm-hmm. miscommunication. So there was a lot of effort being put into trying to figure out how do you deal with the current situation, get everybody stabilized, but particularly some of those areas are going to flood again. Mm. And there were tours made. I went on a tour of that area. Mm. And there's a big creek. That was Seven Mile Creek. I mean, there's a lot of room for that creek to go, but apparently it backs up. When there's big storms, it backs up very quickly, and then it just overflows, and people are going to suffer again. So I don't know. I think the question is good. I can check with Councilmember Johnston. I think Councilmember Welsh was also, her district got impacted. Got to figure out kind of where they're all headed with this and what's the plans for the future. I know that we had the water department, mm-hmm. we had public works, we had the right departments come down and take a look, try to figure out where we go in the future. So hadn't been forgotten. It's just one of those things that now has to been, we had to deal with the immediate situation. I drove by there the other day to take a look at some of the apartments that had to be evacuated. Mm-hmm. It looks like people were back in. Looks like power was restored, people back in. But where do we go in the future? That one I don't know for sure.
All right, let's go next to Taylor. Taylor, good morning. Hi, Taylor.
Good morning, Nick.
Morning.
Good morning to the councilman.
Hey, hi, Taylor.
I wanted to make just a few comments on this Delkey case, if I might. Mm-hmm. I am pro-police all the way, but, and that's a big but in this case, because I think for everything that was done right, there's an equal number of done wrong. And I'll start out with the indictment. It should have not been for first-degree murder. Second or manslaughter would have been appropriate, and I was glad a charge was made, because it certainly was a case that deserved a charge. The defendant has enjoyed 3 years of continuous unemployment, vacation days, sick days, and all that for 3 years waiting on this. And the plea deal, I can see why General Funk took that plea deal, because I think probably a lot of secret polling had gone on, and there was for sure a likelihood of a hung jury. I don't think he would have been able to get 12 people to agree in this case. But my main part goes back to a couple of other things. I think the judge not giving a change of venue was wrong. I think very, very strongly that allowing the former attorney general to be a witness in this case was a serious wrong decision by the judge in this case, and would have carried a lot of weight, but it's and going further for the city of Nashville to not at least fire or suspend this officer to ride out 3 years on the taxpayer's dime, and then for the defense attorney to get up and talk about all the conditions of this, make it sound like someone that's been convicted of speeding or maybe a more serious DUI, and just rub salt into the wound on all the conditions. The officer was allowed to resign rather than be fired, even at the end of this case. So the city did well taking care of themselves, and the police union has spent a fortune of their funds. So there's right and there's wrong in the case, and there's a whole lot of both. That's my point. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks. Actually, Taylor covered it a lot going back and forth. We didn't touch on that. Yeah, he was never behind bars. He was out on bond for the past 3 years and collecting, as he said. And then, you know, the day of the plea deal, he resigned. He was not fired, but resigned. And people had issues with a lot of that. Taylor paid close attention. And, yeah, I think you can see both sides of it. Here's someone who's pro-law enforcement. Mm-hmm. But he definitely thinks, at least in this case, the sentence at least fits the bill.
You're going to have, you're going to have people on both sides of this thing, all the way through, from every particular part of this thing. People are going to have different views on it. And both you and I and all the rest of us weren't back there looking at what the information was, what the facts were, what they had in terms of evidence, and the understanding. So Taylor was mentioning the polling. I think what he was talking about was they have to make a determination. They have to determine whether they think that they can convict based upon a jury of 12 peers.
And like you said, sometimes you just never know. Let's see if we can squeeze in James real quick. We only have about 4 minutes left. James, go ahead, James.
Hi.
Hey.
How you doing, man?
Good. What's on your mind, James?
And I just want to speak a little from. I just want to, you know, I'm calling the show all the time. I just want to speak my mind. And I just heard as his mama, I just heard, I'm a little bit mad, Nick. Hey, Nick.
Yeah.
I just heard.
Wait. Okay, it's kind of hot. I can't make him out enough. I just kept hearing him say, Nick,
he's mad about something. I know that.
All right, we'll see if we can get a clearer line on him in a moment and see if we can get him up close. Maybe on a speakerphone. Meanwhile, we'll take Joe and see if we can get back to him. It's just I just couldn't make him out. Joe, go ahead, Joe.
Okay, it's kind of hot. I can't make him
out. Are you there, Joe?
He's mad about something.
All right, well, our phone calls at the end kind of came up.
Well, I know that James is mad about something, and
something to say. As
if it's my friend Joe, my friend Joe from out in Donaldson, I will tell you
speed bumps coming to his road.
I will tell you that I had a nice conversation with Councilmember Syracuse yesterday, and we may actually see those speed humps. We may actually see that.
Joe is an advocate for certain constituent services, calling the council person and hoping that he can get something done on his street. And he's been doing it for a while, but you've said there's a long list of that, but maybe something's finally happening for him.
So we have a little, it's not really, it's just a discussion that I'm having with friends of mine, and it's basically called the little things that matter.
Yeah.
Okay?
They add up.
So, and they add up, and I think I may have said on this show, we were talking about Oracle, I think, at some point. And it's like the majority of the people in Nashville, besides just knowing about Oracle, are never going to have any involvement with Oracle. They're not going to set foot in the door. They may walk on the greenway in front of it, but they're not really going to be connected with Oracle. But that speed hump that Joe wants, and if we can get that, that's going to have an impact to so many people in that area. And I will tell you, I got my, well, I'm not going to say I got my fingers crossed because we're trying to make it happen. It's the little things.
Yeah.
It's those little things. And the other thing I'll say, Nick, is this has been a really important show.
Yeah.
Listen to Ms. Hambrick. Those are the big things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes we get lost in, you know, discussions about big projects and other stuff. This is a big one, and I understand what people are saying, and understand the hurt and the concern.
And also good, I just want to say, it's always nice to hear from Reverend Fuzz, who many of you know is battling cancer, and he's an amazingly tough guy. He has stage 4, and he continues, and he's open about it, so I'm not giving anything away here.
Sometimes when I'm down,
you think about him.
Think about him, and then I call him.
And me too. And he always has a smile on his face, and the proof that a positive attitude and people who love you can make a difference. Hey, Jim, thank you for coming
sure
on today.
Thing.
It's good to see you.
Good
we'll see you again in a few weeks. How about that? All right. And don't forget, council meeting. Do not miss it tonight.
I will be
there. Folks, I'll be back to wrap things up right after this. Thanks.